Prove it. All right, Max.
Did you ever get to know someone who was going to make his own way to the Crumlin Children's Hospital very shortly if he doesn't behave himself?
I came over here just to learn the language a little bit, to learn to drink Guinness, looking for the nice girls here.
Have you found any nice girls here?
Yes, indeed. Yes, I have.
How many?
I can't answer on this question.
I hear they played an old trick on Pat. You know the slow bicycle race, they put the saddle up very high, didn't they?
Yeah, and you had only two chances to put your leg on the ground or you were eliminated. Sure, I couldn't reach the ground at all, so what could I do?
And did you make it to the end, Pat?
No, I was first over the line. She's down the hill.
You know the prizes for the last over the line, don't you?
It's supposed to be less, but I was first. Well, I was less than everything else, so it didn't matter. At least I got first in something.
What are you doing down in Kerry?
I'm a chef.
Are you?
Yeah.
A bachelor who can cook, girls!
And now I look like this.
Is that okay? Go on. Off you go. Oh, you want this one? You want this one?
Yeah, we'll follow you.
Come on. Okay. Let's see now.
Do you want this mic, Tom?
It's like seeing my going on. Jesus. Where's my drink? Oh. Hang on a second. Please, take her again. Oh, a hungry feeling came o'er me stealing, and the mice were squealing in my prison cell, and me owl triangle. T'would go jingle, jangle, all around the banks of the Royal Canal.
So we were sitting at the table and I had the mouse in the hand. I said, if anybody saw us now, the mouse, I have to run a race. So there's some mustard on the table. So we proceeded to put some mustard behind his legs. When we put the mouse down for the race, it ran that quick. There was a steward's inquiry.
It's not a great game.
Is it not?
No, it's not. And I'd like to say something else as well, Max.
Okay, go on.
You were never a great singer, because I know.
Oh, I'm not a good singer.
I heard
why do you think I'm comparing?
It wasn't Maxie, it was John Giles. John Giles was there. It was Giles-y Dick and Twink. They were my heroes. I was there. I mean, I was in the bad times, the London Hippodrome. I was there. I was at the Dublinovian. I mean, she just wasn't there. She is a charlatan. She does not play a good long ball game. And you know what your problem is, Maxie? You have got no defence. Any striker worth his salt knows he can score with you. And I would like to say... That's it. I'm off.
I have to say poor old Dave.
Now,
we'll tell you in 2 seconds now. Dave, you tell them, will you? The very, very first day that you were here, tell them what happened.
The house of me roof blew off.
And the roof of your house as well.
And the roof of me house. I was on the 9th green Mullingar golf course.
Minding your own business.
I had a 9-putt for money. Playing Radar, the local bandit. There was one shot in it, and the secretary, a very nice man, I might add, who has got a daughter in the audience. Sorry, two daughters, he's been busy this afternoon. That was a cracker.
Go on.
He rushed on to the green, mobile telephone.
Ooh.
Ring home England urgently. Absolutely dead scared, thinking, I haven't won the pools. Somebody might be ill. Or even worse, the girlfriend could be better. The message was to ring me local pub, because that's where I spend most of my time. I got through to the publican, and he says, We've had a storm. You know your lovely house? You're now living in a bungalow.
What are you going to do with the money if you walk away with £1,000 tonight?
Well, there's one guy on the committee working very hard. His name is Paddy Gavin.
He's all disappointed but, now, you see.
Well, he's working at, he's three quarters away to becoming a complete alcoholic. So, so if I got the £1,000, I'd pay for 2 weeks of Paddy in the John of Gods.
Why did you move to Washington?
For the job, for the job.
And what do you do?
I'm a lawyer for the government.
I think you should tell them the full story.
No, I don't think I should.
I think you should. Judy, you want to hear the full story?
Yeah.
Go on.
Taxman.
Taxman! Ah, they like Taxman here, don't they?
Yeah.
Ah, you do.
Can I pull it out?
Of course you can pull it out.
Thanks very much. Oh, sorry. You're welcome to that, my friend.
When I was 16, I fell in love with a girl as sweet as can be. And I remember what Daddy said, and this he said to me. He said, son, you are a bachelor boy. And that's the way I'll stay. Don't be a bachelor boy until the dying day.
No, but think about a real Irish picture. It's a real Irish girl. And it remember me, you see. In Germany we say, an Irish girl without freckles is like a sky without stars. That was the first reason to come to Ireland for me.
So I've stopped to say goodbye, and she sat on this fence, and I've given her a goodbye kiss, and I've actually sort of gone straight over the top.
She
and
fell.
She's leaned on there, and I've gone boom straight on top of her. And
that's his story.
Yeah,
tell us this, Radar, what are the qualities that Maura has that you most admire? Now, this is going on videotape, remember this. We'll show this on your wedding day, right?
Well, she hasn't a bad figure. But it's like me, Owen, we'll manage to get it into the shape at some stage. I think that might be a no tonight. I think that fish is gone anyway.
You see, you met this young woman on Thursday night, and she's into free expression.
And the cheque for £1,000 is made out to the Westmeath Bachelor in 1992, Dave Cowan!